The topic of my presentation focuses on one's foreign interests and its possible social needs, especially related to fertility. First, I'll set up the scene. The period under study is the end of the 20th century and the beginning of the 13th century. In the Estonian context, it means the end of the late Iron Age, it means the end of the prehistory and the beginning of the Middle Ages with the Crusades and Christianization in the beginning of the 13th century. The area under study is north and northeastern part of Estonia, and from there several cemeteries dated to the period mentioned before has been excavated and studied. In general, these sites represent pagan tradition, at least considering the abundant grave goods, but although there are some Christian influences also. In whole area, the burial costumes are similar in all these cemeteries. In general, it's the same. There are differences, of course, in details. And among other things, excavations reveal a lot of information about very richly decorated funerary dresses of women. And clear that the inhabitants in the area shared a common idea about the fashion and also about the proper clothing for burial. First, I introduce briefly the sources that form the basis of the study, and secondly, I'll try to interpret the finds. As an example for visualization, because the time is very limited here, I use a construction made on the basis of the grave, Hukus the sixth grave. And according to the osteological estimations, the woman was about 40 or 50 years old. The reconstruction comprises all the important parts common to the area and the female dress. And it may be worth note that all these costumes have been found from graves that belong to the women older than 17 years or 20 years, so it's mature woman's dress. And how we know about the costume? The main source of the graves is actually the spiral decorations. It was very common to decorate mature woman's dress with this kind of ornaments. And in this area, the main clothing items along this way are apron, and you can see that sometimes it's very light here. Sometimes it's even possible to see the folds of the clothing items, and also the leg wrappings were adorned in this way. The second important part of the costume are ornaments, metal ornaments and accessories. And one of the main parts was breast chains with needles, not always, but usually, and with chain holders. Another typical about was the raised area where you can see the weather calibrated metal blocks.
Yes, can we close some of the lines? Because it's
sheet with bronze coloring, and also my favorites are these hangings made of big spiral tubes, and also numerous bracelets are usually but one of the biggest problems regarding the clothing in that area is the lack of textile remains because of preservation conditions. And the fragments are extremely rare, and they are in very bad condition. But the close study of the textile remains, and also the contemporary supplies from other places, as near as possible, really that it seems that the main color of female costume was blue. The upper garments were made of wool, and the main color was blue, because almost all Roman fabrics that we have from that area, from this area, are blue, dark blue, probably tied with gold. And also in Hooker's in the sixth wave, some blue yarns were collected in the area of apron, in the area of leg wrappings, and also in the stomach area. And also in this study, a very important part is ethnographic parallel. And actually, after the completing the first draft of this reconstruction, it came out that it has striking similarities with 18th century Gothic clothing. It's a small minority. Nowadays. And in the period under study, means the 13th century, I believe that the area under study was at least partly inhabited with the ancestors of present-day Goths. So it's very close connection, actually. And in the context of this study, one of the most important sources is a description of the votes from the end of the 18th century. It was made by Fyodor Dumansky, and it is remarkable because of the drawings and descriptions of clothing of women, and it's more thorough than other descriptions from that period. And for example, he describes the base area of the body costume, and they wore also leather belt adorned with blocks, and also the it was buckled with two rings and with a hook. So it's exactly the same system that it was used in prehistory and in the late Iron Age. And also the Gothic clothing was adorned originally with spiral tube decorations. So there are many connections. That's why I chose this as for the main parallel for the archaeological data. And now I will speak about complex means. It's the complex part of the study. the base for the presentation is the assumption that one very important function of clothing is communication and sharing the information about the social position, like social status, age, pronouns. And I think that the similar costumes of the married woman in this area indicate that this costume was important considering woman's identity and status life in the community. And it was important to stress this identity also in the funeral ritual. But what are these communicative means of this tribe? Is it, and the first question I asked was, is it only meant for funeral? But I assume that the costume of the study was not a special funeral dress because it's obvious that these adornments belong to some kind of festival attire that was meaningful already during the woman's lifetime. And according to Tumansky's description, woman's life was comprised of different stages, such as maiden, newlywed, wife, and old woman. And also these categories are very closely related with fertility. And the transitions between these stages were also stressed by clothing. For example, especially with the headdresses, but also with the ornaments. And first pieces of her jewelry that the girl bought while she was maiden. And for example, also according to Tumansky, she got a leather belt with blocks then. Another important period was after marriage, when the woman was newlywed. Then this is the richest period, considering clothing, then the most abundant jewelry were worn in this period. Important is also the period when she was the only wife. But when she got old and she was old woman, then she desisted most of the jewelry and also most of the adorned clothing items, and wore only a white linen shirt or something like that. And in this context, it's noteworthy that the costume remains discussed today from the late Iron Age. They're also worn by women older than 17 or 20 years. So that's why it is assumed that it was this costume is designed for a married woman. I think it's also important to see that the older woman has been buried in this costume. The woman who according to this description should not wear anymore these rich ornaments related to fertility period. And the most, maybe, I don't know, but the most important but important stage in her life. And that's why I suggest that the women were buried in the not in the costume they wore before the death, but in the costume that was important when they were younger and in fertile age. And there are some details that also stress this, also support this interpretation. For example, if you remember the blue color of the reconstruction also, according to this description, the woman got the blue girdle when she married. And also it is known that the groom gave us a present to the bride, the blue virgin, and also the blue apron. And she doesn't, she didn't wear it anymore when she was old. And also metal jewelry, rich, and that metal jewelry was not only for the beauty, but also because of protection. And it is known that especially in fertile age and in, for example, especially when pregnant, the protection was most needed. And for example, in Estonian ethnographic records say that the apron was meant only for married women and it should give protection while one is pregnant. So the link is also present. I conclude that femininity was stressed in all women's periods, although these women were probably not anymore in fertile age. And I can step even further and suggest that maybe it was also the wedding clothing or wedding costume. Because from later period we had some notes that it was wedding clothes were used in funeral dresses.